A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 25th Feb, Monday. On the front page, you have protests arson rock Itanagar, two dead. So this is regarding Itanagar, the capital of Arunachal Pradesh. Here, the deputy CM's house was set afire over grant of residency papers. So this is regarding permanent residence certificates. So the state government had decided to grant this permanent residence certificate to six non-APST communities, that is non-Arunachal Pradesh Scheduled Tribes communities. So scheduled caste and scheduled tribe status which is granted state-wise. They should be ST in a particular state. So these are non-APST communities. So, since the government decision was to grant them with permanent residence certificates, the other communities in Arunachal Pradesh, 18 indigenous communities, called for a shutdown. So, there was a 48-hour shutdown which was called by 18 indigenous groups. But after this, what happened is this six non-APST communities who demanded that they be granted PRC after their shutdown. So, this became violent. They partly burned down the CM's house to set a fire the CM's house. And in the firing by security forces, two protesters were killed and three were injured. So, this is the violence which happened in Arunachal Pradesh. So, post this, the chief secretary has stated that considering the present situation, government has decided that no further action will be taken in grant of PRCs. So, of course, the losing side is the six non-APST communities because of the violence which happened post that. Then this is police officer, army jawan killed in Kulgam encounter. So, three Jaish-e-Mohammed militants were shot dead and three civilians were among six injured in this Kulgam encounter. And this is India to push for UN ban on Jaish-e-Mohammed chief. So, we are going to make a push again for getting him banned under UN Security Council's 1267 committee. This will be fourth such request in four consecutive years. But we have already seen how China has been blocking our initiative here. Then this is GST on under construction houses cut. So GST on underground construction houses, the tax rate we had seen is 12%. So now it has been reduced by as decided by the GST Council to 5% without the option of input tax credit. So this is there. So this is for normal residential properties. For affordable housing segment, the rate has been reduced to nominal 1% without input tax credit. So, we see previous rates were 12% for affordable housing and 18% for normal housing segment. But then there was in both cases input tax credit was available. Below you have over 170 cars gutted in Chennai fire. So, these were vehicles belonging to a defunct calls taxi company and were parked in an open ground. And 170 such cars, this is a company called U2. In Chennai, where this fire took place. This is just one day after 300 cars were gutted at the Aero India 2019 show in Bengaluru. On page 4, you have action plan for free treatment of hepatitis patients launched. So, this is an initiative of the central government. It is envisaging model treatment centers in all states in future too. So, patients infected with hepatitis B and C virus will be able to avail this free treatment. 8 model treatment centers have already been established in Maharashtra, one in Mumbai too. So, this will provide free treatment for hepatitis C and hepatitis B. Hepatitis C would be launched from March itself and hepatitis B from July. So, this you can see it's a global public health problem, viral hepatitis disease. So, there are actually 5 known types of hepatitis viruses, out of which B and C are known to cause 96% mortality. So, that is why these two have been targeted. Then on page 5, you have fire spreads in Bandipur National Park. So, authorities continue to struggle here to contain the fire. Vast tracts of landscape have been destroyed. And this is smart turn. Karimnagar looks to the sun. So, this is Telangana's Karimnagar, a fast-growing urban center. Here, the municipal body has decided to make rooftop solar panels mandatory for large houses. On page 7, you have a shot in the arm for upgrade of AN-32 aircraft. So, this is Indian Air Force, which is now going to benefit by the upgrade of AN-132. So, Ukrainian manufacturer Antonov Aircraft has offered its new AN-132 replacement for the aging aircraft. So, AN-32 would be replaced by AN-132. Then Assam Hooch tragedy, which had happened, the illicit liquor which was consumed by the people here, its tragedy toll has risen to 143 now. And then this is in a first, Air Force commissions aerial surveillance. So this is hyperspectral imaging, HISIS, which would be used to track suspicious movements in dense forest areas. So this is the aerial surveillance which would take place. It's like spy in the sky. So you can see this is the UAV which is shown here. Then EVM is information under RTI, says CIC. So EVM, electronic voting machine, is information, has that is what the Central Information Commission has ruled under the RTI. So the information has to be provided. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Terror Timeline. So this is regarding Financial Action Task Force taking its decision to put Pakistan in the grey list again, continue to keep it in the grey list. So this says, the editorial says that the FATF must impress upon Pakistan the need to take meaningful action. And second editorial is safety nets. So this is regarding new rules on unregulated deposit schemes. So like this would affect the chit funds too and other such deposit schemes. So it says new rules need to be backed up with proper checks. And then the lead article is after Pulwama, sorry response. It says the government and opposition must state their policy for security and reconciliation in Jammu and Kashmir. So the situation in Jammu and Kashmir is dire, both on civilian side as well as security side. So this is spoken of here. And this is deodorizing sewage. So India's cities are drowning in waste. So in the waste accumulation and solid waste management is a huge concern. It causes this stink too. So this article talks about that. Then on op-ed page, you have this article, Old Challenges in Building a New Kerala. So this is regarding post-Kerala floods, the planning and development here. It needs decentralization. So that is what this article speaks of. On page 10, you have risk pay raised for paramilitaries. So paramilitary forces deployed in Jammu and Kashmir, Nixalism hit areas will get a risk pay as such too. So this is there. And this is regarding this front page news regarding Arunachal Pradesh, the permanent residence certificate. And this is JUDFIF change name bypass ban. So Pakistan government had a day before banned these terrorist organizations, but then Pakistan newspaper reports that these organizations continue to function here. They have changed the banners outside their offices and collection centers as such for both JUD and FIF, and they continue to function. On page 11, you have SC eviction order only against encroachers. So the Supreme Court order which came on eviction of forest dwellers, it says these are only on encroachers. Forest rights claims undergo due verification process, and after that, those who are encroachers have been identified and they have to be removed. Then on the international page, you have this entire timeline of US President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, their talks. So the two leaders, have now a second talk which is scheduled for over 2 days over the next week. So this is the entire timeline of the previous talks, how it happened. So you can see North Korea has asked Trump to ignore critics. So the upcoming summit which is going to take place, there should be a positive environment in that. The previous summit had taken place in Singapore, and now it's been 8 months to that. After that, they are going to meet again for the second summit in Vietnam. On page 13, you have NPS, Minimum Assured Return Scheme on the cards. So Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority of India is considering a minimum assured return scheme, MARS. So this will be for subscribers of NPS, National Pension Scheme, so that they can get a minimum assured return. Then on Mondays, you have business review coverage. So here you have this coverage with a graph which shows, which talks about central public sector enterprises. So how many central public sector PSUs are profit making, which are loss making, is shown here. Consistent success, consistent failures, the this is also a graph showing the number of employees and the loss as such. Because recently it was in news that BSNL and MTNL are having, a significant part of their revenue being used to pay the employees. Then below you have again regarding Jet Airways, the rescue plan, the bankers-led rescue plan, which has been put forth and which has been approved now. So this talks about the questions lurking about who will commit fund into this firm, which is having 7,242 crore negative net worth. And this is an article saying balancing risk with reward. So tightening of mutual fund norms, it says, needs dedicated handling. Then on the last page you have cell-based meat may soon find its way at your to your dining table. So Maharashtra government and Institute of Chemical Technology have teamed up with US-based Good Food Institute to set up a lab in India by 2019 end. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit a website, asia.com, and also there's a separate current affairs course in which detailed current affairs video lectures uploaded. Also, current affairs PDFs are uploaded on the website. The monthly and daily compilations, they are freely available here. You can download them as well. So that is it. Thank you.